Hello everyone. So in this video, I'll show you how to use Google Cloud Data Transfer Service and transfer the data from AWS S3 bucket. So for this video, I have already set up an S3 bucket, and this S3 bucket has certain files over here. All right. Now I want to move these files to Google Cloud Storage bucket. So I'll go to Google Cloud Console. And I'll select my desired project. Then I'll create an Google Cloud bucket if you don't have it already. I already have a Google Cloud bucket over here. I want to move all the files from this S3 bucket to this Google Cloud bucket. Right? For doing this, we will be using data transfer service. I'll click on data transfer. And I'll click a data transfer job. Create a data transfer job. So data transfer jobs or data transfer service can be used for migrating from S3 bucket, Azure storage containers or blob containers, and the Google Cloud bucket itself. Between two Google Cloud buckets, if you want to transfer the data, you can do that, as well as a list of URLs. You can put the list of URLs inside a CSV file, all right, and you can upload it over here. Okay. This demo, I would be using S3 bucket. So I'll put my S3 bucket name is this. Then it will require credentials, right, with the S3 bucket permission. So I'll go to identity and access management. And I'll create a new user with programmatic access. So I'll click on this, add user. And I'll call a user as data transfer user. All right, and I'll give this user the access type as, or the AWS credential type as, access key or programmatic access. Next, for permission part, if you want, you can create a granular permission which gives the access to the specific bucket from where you want to transfer the data. For this demo, I'll be using S3 full access permission, and I'll create the user, and then I'll use the access key and secret access key. Copy this, paste it over here. Copy this and paste it over here. Right. Additionally, you can also define filters. Like if you want to move the files for a specific time range, all right, you can define the time range. All right. If you have any suffixes, all right, or prefixes, you can use those prefixes over here, right, to include or exclude the files. So you have advanced filtering option also over here available. I'll click on next. I'll choose my destination bucket. Destination bucket is the bucket which we created. And I'll select this bucket. If you have any folder path, you can specify this folder path as well. All right. You can put the data transfer job name. So I'll call it as something like this, today's date. All right. And I can do like a recurring job. All right. So I can when to overwrite if the files are available. All right, you can define that as well. Sorry, it's not a recurring job. It's basically define if the file is already available, then what needs to be done, right? You want to overwrite it or you want to create a different copy, right? And what you want to do with the files at the source end. So you can also when to delete at the source end. So you can also define that. I'm not defining anything over here as of now. I'll say next. Now here you can define, is it a one-time job or a recurring job? So at once means it will run right now and it will stop. If you want to move the job, or if you want to run this job every day and move the files from S3 bucket to Google Cloud Storage every day, then you can say a everyday job as well. As well as you can define a custom figure. I'll call it as a one time job, right? And I'll finally click on create. And the job is created. All right, it's in queue state, right? After some time, the job will start. Right, and once it is succeeded, you will see succeeded over here, and all the files, right, would be copied from S3 bucket, right? So it's in progress, which means it has started copying the files. So let me quickly go to the Google Cloud bucket and see if anything is copied yet or not. Yeah, here it is. So all the files which were present inside my S3 bucket over here are now present inside the Google Cloud Storage as well, right? So this is how the data transfer service works. This is how you configure it. I hope you like this video. Thank you.